Namaste. Today we are going to see an episode with Mahavatar Babaji during our visit to Mahavatar Babaji cave. He has taken me to a very specific place as it happened in 2008 September. This was a first time experience for me. Let us attentively listen to this and understand. During September, from 20th to 6th of October, the Pitrupaksha was in operation. During this time, after completing our daily rituals to our forefathers, on 23rd, I was in a dhyana for a longer time. Mataji had gone down, but I was continuing. I did not know that she has already completed her dhyana and gone down. Suddenly some message came to me, come to cave. Because on March 2021 only we visited, not even 6 months has elapsed. I was little thrilled. Why Babaji is calling me to cave at this time? Because the season was concluding. And it was not a season for us to go. After the call has come, I realized he wanted me to come to the cave. I came down and announced to Mataji that I want to go to cave. She said, what about me? I said, you are also coming. Maybe next day to next day, just we casually announced in the group that there is a call and we are going to Babaji cave. But suddenly, spurt of members wanted to join. It went on, increasing. Finally, it stopped at 16 members wanted to come with us. What we wanted to go by car from Delhi, we had to make a bigger car, van. Subsequently, we made a mini bus and 16 members went to Babaji cave from 26th of October to 30th of October, just 4-5 days. But the members have joined. The tour itself was a doubtful affair for us because around the 19th and 20th, there was a cloud burst. There was heavy damage. Many people killed in Nainital. In Ramnagar area, the Garjya Devi temple, except the temple, including the bridge and the shopping area, was totally washed out. Many members did not express anything, but each member had a fear whether the tour will go on or not. This time we wanted to explore something because there was a call to go to Mansa Devi also. So, we took a decision to go to Haridwar, a holy bath in River Ganga, go to Mansa Devi temple, from there to Chandi Devi temple, take darshan of Ganga Mata Aarti also in the evening, and to continue our journey to Babaji cave, which was a 14 hours journey. But just a week before, miracle, the entire area was almost washed out. In many news, it was flashed. Many people died. All roads were cut. With these conditions, many members had reservation but did not express. But all arrived at Delhi on 26th and we continued our journey. When we reached to just to look at the Garjya Devi temple, the damage that has happened was painful.
You could see the video as well as the group photo. The group photo is of our previous visit. We are all standing on the bridge. That particular bridge is almost totally wiped out. And behind us, you could see the Garjya Devi temple, which is now you can see in the video how devastating was the fury of the rain and the floods.
On the way we could see several landslides. Our vehicle was difficult to pass because still the rectification process were underway. With some difficulty, we reached Cochinchina. We took a stay place at a Joshi guest house as usual. We stayed there. Next time morning, we went to Babaji Cave. This time, Babaji Cave was looking like a dense forest, contrary to what we have seen earlier. Earlier, it was a dry place. This time, because of the rain and the seasonal change, instead of March, we went in October, the last leg of the season. It was a dense forest. Within the forest, within the hill, we had to take a walking, trekking. That we will discuss in another video. This, as I mentioned in my earlier message in the group, that on the call of Mahavatar Babaji, we are going. In fact, I wanted to go with very less member. 16 member was okay with us because the cave itself can hold only maximum of 8 persons. So we thought that in 2 sessions we can spend our time in meditation. I went for meditation in the first batch. I was there in the second batch also. Myself and Mataji sat together. Within maybe 1 or 2 minutes of my sitting, it was an everlasting memory, everlasting experience. Babaji appeared. Later, I also shared this with the members in the cave itself, and I wanted other members to experience some of the experience what I experienced. In a matter of 2 minutes, I was nowhere. Babaji appeared and took me to a place. It was unheard to me, but he has taken me to that place. Like Shambhala, this place also, Dhyana Mandir, Jnana Gunj, Siddha Ashrama, Siddha Mandir, Dhyana Mandir. It is deep inside the, in a valley. It is not on the peak. Within the peak, in a valley, deep inside, not visible, not accessible to anybody physically. Very big gardens, temples, hundreds and thousands of people in meditation. Apsara like beautiful women, all like everybody, every individual there with full of life. Many are in meditative, many siddhas. Something was mesmerizing for me in about few minutes. I could have the darshan of Vasishtha, Vishwamitra, Gautama, Kripacharya, Atri, Pulastya, some yogis, some siddhas like Gokarnath, Nandideva, Pambati Siddhar, Chatai Muni, Hidai Kadar, Kakabhujandar, Bhishmacharya, Kripacharya. So many individuals, so many Mahapurushas were shown to me by Babaji in a matter of minutes. They were all wandering, they were all walking and going on here and there in their physical form. Babaji gave an account that Vishwamitra brought Rama and Lakshmana to this place. With the entrance of Rama and Lakshmana here, only they were able to control the Danavas, the Rakshasas in the Ramayana war. Harishchandra was there. Parasara, Pungava, Vyasa Maharishi, so many Siddhas in Siddha Ashrama. I have never come across the Siddha Ashrama anywhere. As per the account of Mahavatar Babaji, it is very clearly mentioned in many texts of Purana. Even in Valmiki Ramayana, this place is mentioned. But I have not gone through Valmiki Ramayana. I have read only very simplified version of Ramayana of Rajagopalachari. This was a mesmerizing darshan for me. I do not know what for Babaji called me. It was always I was wondering why he called me. He said, nobody enters here Any individual who wants to attain this place can do only through meditation. No other way of entering here. During the time where Babaji was staying in this Mahavatar Babaji cave, most of the time the Siddhas had taken Babaji there only, in Siddhashrama only. He was given full training of all the Siddha cultures. All the Siddhas' teachings were received by Mahavatar Babaji, except the Kriya Kundalini, where Babaji was imparted at Agastya Mala. All other knowledge Babaji got in Siddhashrama only. This was the account what was given to me by Mahavatar Babaji. It is a very thrilling place, full of ice. Many places there is no record in recent history, that's what Babaji says. All are in Purana, we will have to search Purana and here and there, collect information. I don't have the habit of collecting information, so whatever I have read or studied in my childhood only comes to my memory. Other than this experience, very thrilling to understand this. Many yogis, yogins, sannyasins, siddha purushas, sadhus, sannyasins, all those who renounced their life are seen there. It is a full of entertainment. No sun, no moon comes there, but still the place is illuminated with full of lights, no scarcity for water, no scarcity for fruits and vegetables. All sorts of animals are there, all sorts of birds are there, all sorts of lives are there. Babaji said it is almost close to Manasa Sarovar. The distance between Manasa Sarovar and Babaji cave may be around 600 to 700 kilometers. In between somewhere it is located in a dense valley. Not only that, Babaji gave several speciality about this Siddhashrama. It is a supernatural land within the land, which is Siddhashrama. It is a divine place for any kind of spiritual journey for an individual. After this video, I want many of the members to explore this in dhyana only, because Babaji himself says one can attain this place only through dhyana, not by in physical form. So the only way is through dhyana meditation. After this video is released, please kindly explore this. Let us explore. It is located in a very secret land under the ground. It looks like as though we are getting into the ashrama through a lift full of icy cliffs. As per the account given by Mahavatar Babaji, it is in between Mahavatar Babaji cave, Manasa Sarovar and Kailash Parvat. Somewhere it is very difficult to locate and physically approach. It will not be visible to anybody. Nobody can go there. So with the description available through this video, maybe some members can meditate and find out. Including me, I will also meditate and explore only. It is the grace of Mahavatar Babaji has taken me to that place. I must be so thankful. I must be so humble before Babaji. I do not know how he has selected me to take to this place, and for this reason he called me to unseason, that just before our visit, 8 days, 9 days before our visit, there was a heavy cloud burst and heavy damage was caused. In spite of that one, we took risk and we went to attend to the call of the Mahavatar Babaji, and we returned safely without any kind of problem. Not even we had no, if at all there was a rain during that day, we would have cancelled our trip. We would not have been able to go to Mahavatar Babaji cave trekking itself, because all our tickets were confirmed and our ticket was cancelled 4 times or 3 times by airlines. 5 of our members' tickets were cancelled. So we had to cancel and we have to spend a lot of money for rebooking the ticket. The first thing we did after reaching Delhi was to get a refreshment and go to the next door of the travel agent and book our fresh ticket as our further journey was cancelled. With this condition, we took up the journey. Maybe for this experience, we have been called. That is what I assume. Once we are spiritually inclined, Babaji says, we will be in touch with Siddhashrama. And once we have contact with the Siddhashrama, we will never get disconnected from the Siddhashrama. This is the fact what Babaji has described to me, which I am explaining to you here. Siddhashrama is very rare, not only for the human beings, even for the animals and all other creatures. Only the creatures which are endowed with some kind of kindness from the divinity can enter there. Or those creatures or those living beings who are there may be specially blessed beings only are there. Only through hard work, only through hard sadhana, only through total dedication and trust, one can try to enter the Siddhashrama through meditation only. There is no other way. Babaji says in Siddhashrama, even our ancestors were living earlier. Some of the selected ancestors who are too much of virtuous have been staying, have been given asylum in the Kutira, in Siddhashrama. So there is a great confident that our forefathers would have been there. Because Babaji also gave an account that because this call came during Pitrupaksha, Babaji gave me some secrets that my father immediately attained moksha on his leaving the body, and he was not qualifying to be a Pitru, but he remained Pitru only for the sake of emancipation of other two forefathers, my forefathers, his father and that lineage to be uplifted. So during this Pitrupaksha, with the rituals offered by me, was accepted by all the Pitrus, and all my Pitrus have reached the emancipation level of going to the rightful place where they were supposed to be there. So there is no karma to be paid by me also, paid by us also, to our Pitrus. But as a matter of fact, we will continue to offer for other Karunya Pitrus, which we will continue to do so long we are alive. As per the account of Mahatar Babaji, Upanishads, Smriti, Shruti, Vedas, especially the oldest Veda, Rig Veda, Ramayana and Mahabharata contain more information about Siddhashrama. Some of the old members of this WhatsApp group and YouTube group can explore and find out the secrets of Siddhashrama as explained by Mahatar Babaji. Babaji also guaranteed that the persons or the individuals who reach the highest stage in sadhana, who are very sincere, who are likely to have confidence of getting enlightenment, will definitely have the darshan of Siddhashrama, will definitely reach Siddhashrama. That can happen only through the blessings and guidance of their guru. And as far as we are concerned, we have the greatest guru with us, and we are with the greatest guru. That trust alone is sufficient for us to reach Siddhashrama. In this place, all Siddhas, whenever there some dangers come, whenever they are ignored, whenever Kali Yuga approaches, They escape and go to this safe place. They live there thousands of years and millions of years also. Till the Satya Yuga comes, they will remain there. There is no aging, there is no time factor, there is no death for those who are in Siddhashrama, is the message derived by me from Avatar Babaji. Naked eyes are these two eyes will not be useful to see Siddhashrama, for which you need to have the special eye opened, which we have given enough training for the members. Please explore and you will be in Siddhashrama. There is no doubt about it.
Om Sadguru Babaji Namaha. Om Sadguru Babaji Namaha. Om Sadguru Babaji Namaha.